Rajesh Argiddi from WIT Solapur. Today we will see the doubly linked list operations, that is insertion of a node in the doubly linked list. Today we will cover the topic inserting a node at beginning of the list in a doubly linked list. The learning outcome of today's session: student will be able to explain the operations of inserting a node at beginning in the doubly linked list. Let us see the definition of doubly linked list. A linked list is a linear data structure in which the elements are not stored at contiguous memory locations, whereas in the array the memory allocations are contiguous. It is a data structure consisting of collection of nodes which together represents a sequence. That is called as a linked list. Now let us see the structure of the node in a doubly linked list. As we know, in the singly linked list we have two parts, that is data part and address part for a particular node. But in doubly linked list, node is an element in a linked list. It consists of three parts. Instead of two parts, it is now three parts. In singly there were two parts, in doubly linked list there are three parts. Which are the three parts? The first part is called as a data part, which contains the information, may be integer, character or any data type. Second part contains the address part, which is the pointer, which is pointing to the next node, or it is holding the address of the next node. And the third part is again address part, which will be pointing to the previous node of the node, or it is storing the address of the previous node in the list. The figure is like this. This is a data part where you can store the integer, character, float or any data type. This is address part. It will be the pointer, which will be pointing to the next node, or it is storing the address of the next node. This part, address previous, which will be storing the address of previous node, or which is pointing to previous node. Now one more difference we see here, it is two arrows are there, means traversal in doubly linked list is possible forward and reverse. With this forward and this is reverse. Now this is simple example of a doubly linked list where three nodes are shown: the first node, second node, third node, and this is a pointer which is pointing to the first node of the list. That is called as either head or start. Now here this 100 indicates that the address, this is taken as a, to understand the concept, we have assumed that this address is 100, but as per computer it may be any number. For the sake of understanding, we have considered these values. These are showing as the address of the memory location. So at memory location 100, this node is stored, where data part is 10, integer data. 200 is the address of the next node that is stored over here. So that address is held by this particular next pointer. And this second node consists of stored at location 200, where address is, say again, the value is say 10, and here the address part of the previous node, means previous node is stored at 100. That 100 is stored over here. So the starting address of this particular node is stored by previous pointer, and this is the address held by the next node, that is starting address of this particular, that is 300, is stored at the next pointer of this particular node. And in a first node, since there is no previous node, so this particular part, previous next pointer, is made as a null. And if this is the last node, then the last node, in the last node, the next pointer will also indicate to null because there is no any other further node. This is the structure or example of a doubly linked list. Now the types of insertion of a node in a doubly linked list. There are three types. Insertion can be made at the beginning of the list, insertion can be made at the end of the list, and insertion of an element or a node can be made at the specific location in the doubly linked list. Now let us see today the insertion of a node or element at the beginning of the list. We'll see the algorithm and how to write the code in the next slides. Now this is the algorithm for insertion of a node at the beginning of the doubly linked list. The first step, first of all, we need to create a new node and read the data from the user that is to be inserted in the node. Maybe integer, now we integer data type, and assign null to the new node previous, because it will be the first node, so the previous link or previous pointer will be shown as a null. So this can be shown, new node next previous is equal to null. The second step, check whether list is empty or not. This can be checked. If head is equal to null, then we can say that there are no nodes are present in a list. If head is not equal to null, means head is having some address, means there are nodes are present. If it is so, if it is empty, then what we have to do? We have to assign node, new node next, whatever the memory new node is created. Okay, so the next pointer should be assigned as a null. And new node and assign head to the new node, or the address of the new node should be stored at pointer head, so that now head will point to the first node. If node is not empty, it means there are nodes are present in the list, then what to do? Then new node next should be assigned to head. And new node should be assigned to head. Or rather, in the fourth step, if it is not empty, then assign head to new node next and new node to head. Now the implementation of the insertion of a node at the beginning in a doubly linked list. Now first of all, first step is that create a node, new node. Now for that, this node is created, where assuming that it is stored or memory allocation is done at location 100, and that node is held by the pointer called as a new node. So for that we need to declare a structure a node type, then the two three parts. One is integer data type. Then the pointer next and previous two pointers are declared to the structure of the type structure node. Then as a variable to the structure, new node is declared, and head is also declared, and head is assigned to a null initially. This is a function. Now here in this code, in this particular PPT, we are going to discuss the code for the inserting a node at the beginning. So with a malloc structure, with a malloc, okay, of typecasting struct node, size of this structure, those many bytes will be allocated, and the starting address of that will be allocated to the pointer new node. Second step is that treat the data to be inserted in the node and assign null to the new node previous. So this can be done by printf and scanf. We can read the data, and new node previous, this part is made null since it is the first one, And if suppose it is head is equal to, initially head is null. So we will call this particular part new node next. This is made as null, and then new node, the address of this new node 100 will be allocated to head. So this is a second step of the algorithm, and this is the code required. And in the next part, if it is not empty, then assign head to new node next and new node to head. That is, it is if it is empty, then this is for if it is not empty. If it is not empty means already this node is there. So this particular part is created with a new node. Then new node next, this particular part is should be stored address of this particular node. Now right now that is held by this head. So so with this statement new node next is equal to head. So initially head was here, this address 10 was there. So this 100 is stored over here. Then the next is what? This head should be assigned to the first node of the list. So this is how we have done it. Now take a pause over here. How many bytes are required to store one node of a doubly linked list? We require 12 bytes because we require 4 bytes for integer, 4 bytes for 2 each pointer, so 12 bytes are required. This is the entire code of a doubly linked list. I hope these are the references. I hope you understood how to insert a linked list. Thank you.